Okay, so I think how I'm going to go about this is starting from the smallest box to the biggest. So, shoes, blaster, and then costume. So, let's get to the shoes. So the shoes come in a box, as most shoes do. And it comes with the Stormtrooper logo, and then Shepperton Designer Studios and the website, where you can go check out all their other stuff that they sell. I'll have it in the link down in the description below. And here's the contents. So it comes with, I believe these are like foot comforters, so like that way your foot like feels more comfortable in the shoe. Those are nice. I might try them. And then here's the actual shoe, and it comes, oh, look at the bag. Look at that bag. That's a dope looking bag. And then let's take a look at the shoe. I already had a look at the shoe, but like I want to take a better look at it because I have to try it on. Ooh. Ooh, that is nice. These are shoes that you do not take out unless you're in the outfit. These are shoes that you either just leave on a mannequin until you wear them, or you just don't take them out the bag to wear anywhere else. But those look swanky, if I'm using that word right. I don't know. And then it comes with a little Stormtrooper logo at the bottom right there, as you can see. These shoes are very well made, has Shepperton Design Studios written here, and the size. In the UK, I'm an 8.5, which in America is an 11, and I'm 6'3", and I have a size 11 foot, which is hilarious. But the shoes are amazing. I'm not going to take the other one out because it looks identical to this one. And at first I thought there was only one shoe in here, but apparently it's under more paper and in another bag. So that's really sick. I like the bag, I like the shoes. Very well packaged here. So let's just put all that back in there. So yeah, that's the shoes. Now let's move on to the second bit, which is the blaster, the E11 blaster. So it comes with, you know, Stormtrooper logo, blaster on the front. This is actually the collector's edition, so it comes with the stand with a serial number. They had a cosplay version, but it was all rubbery and plastic and had like an orange tip, like you'd see on like airsoft or Nerf guns to, you know, show, hey, this is a prop gun, or like this is a toy gun or anything. And it comes with the instructions on the side, so it shows the stand itself, the ammo holder that you install into it, and then it comes with information. So the blaster used a World War II machine gun as the basis for the iconic movie prop. So, and the actual blaster has the serial number of the gun that it was based off of, which is really cool. And then the power pack is accurately cast from the original Hengstler counter, serial number of the blaster being installed in the power pack, and cross-referenced on both the blaster display and packing box, which is cool. And then the T-tracks are sprung into the barrel vent holes, even the internal rifle blaster can be detected. So that's cool. And then the ammo magazine is retractable. This reduces the overall size for storage. That's smart. And is really neat tweak. Neat tweak? And the blaster stand is made from carbon fiber and laser cut acrylic. Stand displays the serial number of the blaster. So this is actually so cool. And let's open the box up. And it has the name of the guy who made it. And the serial number right here on the box. And then like the address and stuff. So, enough about the box, let's open it up, and boom. So this is the contents. So that right there is a certificate of authenticity, which is amazing. This is probably the second or third product that I have that has a certificate of authenticity, because I found these little figurines back here were made by professional sculptors, and they came with certificates of authenticity. So this is the third thing that basically comes with it, and it has the serial number. And it says, this certificate verifies that the product with the following serial number has been crafted by Shepperton Design Studios using workmanship materials that replicate the originals. So this is really cool. So they have, I'm not going to get like, you know, the stand out because I'm going to wait till I get back to Florida to put it on display. But that's the contents. You have the blaster, the ammo, the stand, the plastic bits or the glass that comes with to like hold up the stand. And a little card that has the guy's name on it, and phone number, and website, etc. But let's look at the blaster. It's one of the things that I found really surprising about this is the blaster is lightweight. Let me close the box, so that way. The box is kind of difficult to close. You have to push in these cardboard bits in the side of it, and then you have to... What is happening? Close properly. There we go. What's nice is that it has a little carry handle and everything. So yeah, here's the blaster and here's the little ammo thing. I'm not going to put it in. I'm going to put it in for when I try on the costume. But basically, this is very hard to get out. When one of the best things I found is that if you twist it out, like you just like maneuver it back and forth and twist it out. It has a little O-ring on it, so that way it's like a good fit, I guess. But here's the actual blaster, and like I said, one of the surprising things is that it was incredibly lightweight. But you can see the detail they put into this. And like I said on the box, this is actually modeled off a World War II blaster that they used for the original movie. And then you have the scope, which is so small, no wonder the original Stormtroopers missed everything they tried to shoot. Do-do-tsh, that's a roast right there. And then the serial number, and then grip, very comfortable, like very nice to hold. And it has like the wires and everything. This blaster is so well detailed, and it even has the A, R, and S, so like S for safety, rifle, and then assault, I guess. I don't know. Don't really know much about real life guns, but I do know about E-11s and Nerf blasters and basically every single sci-fi weapon there is in the world. And you can't look through the scope, but it does have this really nice, little picture in there to like show like little sight and everything. And yeah, so this is very nice to hold, very lightweight, like I said. And like I said, this just goes in here. Now you see this back bit, I don't know if you can tell, but it has like little wavy lines. So if you get it, you have to put the wavy lines facing towards you inside, and then you just push it in and it fits in like that. It's very well made, very well constructed, and I just love the overall look of it and the feel of it. Very cool. Definitely going to be putting this on display on my prop table when I get back to Florida. So let's put that down right there. And now to the big box. I'm going to show you. I'm going to show you the size of this box. So basically, this is the shipping box. The brown box is the shipping box, and then it came in a white box with everything in it, and there's the helmet and everything. So, let's do this. Put you back down right there. Alright, so let's start off with probably my favorite part of this whole outfit. The head. This is so well detailed. I love the place that made these so well detailed. I'm not going to get everything out of their boxes, but like the helmet is just so cool. Check that out. Looks like the original. And then to put it on, you have to, because like when I first put it on, I put it on like this. But it was discovered that you put it on like that. And then you do that. And then everything in the room now looks green. Don't know if you can hear me very well. Should really get a microphone, like one of my friends suggested. But anyway, that is the helmet. Oh man, it's so sick. One issue that I had was that I can't see like below me, so I once like knocked into a cardboard box and hurt my foot. But overall, the build quality is amazing. And yeah, so that's really all I have to say about the helmet. The helmet is probably my favorite part of the whole costume. So I'm gonna set that down there, put it back in its thing later. Okay, I'm gonna keep everything together so that way I know. Alright, let's see. Here we go, what's this? Ah, this is the bodysuit! So you have to put the black bodysuit on, because this is what they wore for the original. And it's stretchable, so it will fit me. It's like one size fits all, basically, but it's usually meant for like people who are over 6 foot, like myself. So it will stretch, and it will fit perfectly. There it is right there. Looks like kind of like something you'd get with like a Batman outfit, like for Halloween. Very cool. Let's put that there. All right, so now we have all the main white bits for the entire outfit. Let's see. Here we have the belt, which is very, very long. And I do believe that is, yeah, it comes with Velcro attached, which is very nice. You'll see it all out of the box when it's like, I don't really want to get it out of this packaging because there's a lot of plastic and a lot of bags, so like it's going to be hard, kind of hard to figure out where everything goes. But it does come with Velcro on it, and then it has little belt attachments on it, which is really cool. That also, I believe, fit with Velcro. Yeah, I think they do fit with Velcro. But yeah, so that's the belt right there. Very well designed and detailed. Let's just put it down on the floor. Just hoping we don't break anything, because this is very expensive. Okay, that's more bubble wrap. That's another bag. Okay, what else do we have? We have, what is in this? I saw this and I didn't know what it was. Like, it's just giant. Okay, so this is taped together. Why do you have to be taped? Whoops, okay. Let's just pull it out. Okay, oh wow. So, looking at it, I believe these are the shin pads. They look like they mean shin pads. Okay. Like I said, if you want to skip to where I actually put on the whole outfit and stuff, I'll have it on the screen somewhere so you can skip to that part. But this is just me like taking a look in the box. Alright, so main body plate, that looks very detailed. One of the body plates there, which is cool, comes with like little belt, little inserts, and then more chest pieces, but one right there. And then you've got, I believe this is like the lower part, so it goes like around like your waist and like down to your legs. That's very cool. Oh my god, there's so many pieces in here. Jesus! I don't really want to get out of the bat. Let me take a look inside. I believe these are the arm guards that go like on the shoulders and everything. So, like I said, gonna get everything out of the packaging when I try it on. And so you can get a better look. And then I believe these are more arm pads or something that go like down on your wrist. Because like these look like a thinner kind of like opening compared to the other ones. So that's that. And then what else? Oh my god. So many things. What's this? Oh, this is the, what do they call it? Proximity bomb. What's it called? I can't remember the name of it, but I have it on the screen. But this is like the grenade. Like, it's a grenade that they throw in the movie. It's in the game as well that you throw. It's very cool. And it goes on like the back of the belt, which I believe that's why there was some Velcro on the back of the belt, because I think it was there. And then another big white bag with more kind of, there's a lot of like guarding stuff that goes around. I'm guessing this kind of goes somewhere on your legs, because like, you know, you can tell by the size this goes like somewhere, but like a big area, so probably legs somewhere. Very cool, right? That. And then what else we have? We got the gloves, which are rubber gloves, which are pretty interesting. And then it has like white bits on there, which is very nice. It's a good thing you don't have to add them to the thing while you're constructing yourself into it. And then this is the neck seal. Now this is like supposed to go around your neck, so that way the Stormtrooper helmet fits well on your head like that. So that's really cool. So neck seal. And then finally, under everything else, we have the back part. This goes on the back, which is very, what I love is, like I said, this is made from the original molds that they used from the original movie, and the actual guy that made it for the original movie made them like this. And the detail is just exquisite. I just love this so much. This is definitely going on a mannequin. And then there's bubble wrap, bubble wrap, bubble wrap, bubble wrap, bubble wrap. And then what's this? Ah, so this is a booklet that he gave me before that has everything you can buy in it. So, you can buy X-Wing helmets. You can buy Stormtrooper armor, white, black. They have a silver one, but that one is £10,000. 10,000. And then he actually sells R2, like life-size R2 units that are about 250? 2.5? 250, I guess? Yeah. And then the blaster, the holster. Where's the holster? I wonder where the holster is. Maybe it's in like the side. Came with the holster. I'll find it. You'll see it in the actual thing. But yeah, so that's really cool. Has a bit of history in the back. Yeah, has a bit of history right here. It talks about how he came to make these for Star Wars and everything. Very cool. And then the instruction manual. So I'm gonna definitely be following this. The person said that this should take 5 minutes to put on and you'll need help the first time, but you'll get the hang of it. And then it comes with like all the instructions of how to put it on and everything. So that's sick. And then I believe this, yes it is, certificate of authenticity. That says, certificate verifies that the product with the following serial number, blah blah blah, studio workmanship, material, and it has battle number mark 300079. So that's cool, and it has a little thing, and a Stormtrooper imprint, which is very cool. And then, I believe that's everything out of the box. Yeah, the holster is here somewhere. So, now that I've gotten everything out of the box, we're going to go unpackage it, everything, and then we're going to try it on. So, let's get to becoming a Stormtrooper.
Alright, so here is everything out of the box and out of the paper. Still in bags, but you know, you get a much better, clearer look. Instructions, so lady said this should take about 5 minutes to do. Hopefully that time is right. So here's the first part of many, so let's get started.
Coming with me. Okay, so this is the final product.
Brilliant.
All here. It took about 10 minutes to get on, but you know, it's our first attempt of getting it on. I'm trying not to break everything.
Woo! Woo!
You know, the weather here in England doesn't really help the conditions that are in the suit. But looking at it, it's so sick. It's so cool, you got all the great detail, like on the mask and the blaster, even on the little grenade on the back. It's so cool. So, I'm trying to get... Okay, hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure you, again, like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.
Okay, while we were at Alice and Nima's, we had a knock on the door. Alice opened the door and we were quite shocked to see this person.
You're all coming with me.
I'm Luke Skywalker, I'm here to rescue you.